I'm going to show you how you can easily use your PS4 controller wirelessly or wired on your PC to play any game you like, such as Forza, Warzone, or even Fortnite. Let's do this. First off, just make sure your controller is turned off, and you can also turn off your PS4 to ensure your controller doesn't connect to that by mistake. If you want to do this wired, then just plug your controller into your PC, but to connect it wirelessly, you will want to go to your Bluetooth settings. On Windows, go to Settings, Devices, then Bluetooth. From here, add a new Bluetooth device, and whilst it's searching, hold down the Share button and the PS button on the controller at the exact same time until the light bar starts flashing white really rapidly. When it's flashing, the controller is in pairing mode, so you should now see it listed in the Bluetooth devices to connect to. Click it and connect to your controller. With your controller connected directly to Windows like this, you will be able to play games that support the DualShock 4 without any other steps, but some games such as Forza Horizon 4 or Minecraft Java Edition don't have support for a controller, so now I'm going to show you how you can seamlessly still use your controller to play those games. Head down to the description of this video and click the link which will take you to the download page for an application called Input Mapper. Whilst you're at the description, also please consider subscribing if you do want more PlayStation tips and discussions, as according to YouTube Analytics, only 2% of you are subscribed, so let's get that number up. On the download site, just download the most recent version and then run the installer. Start the app to finish the installation and then also restart your PC. Now your PC is back on, you can just click the PS button on your controller and it should automatically ask you if you want to connect back to it. But if not, then go through the whole pairing process again. Once your controller is connected to your PC, start the Input Mapper software. Once you start it, your controller should disconnect and then reconnect, and you might get a ton of error messages in the bottom right. I actually have no idea why these pop up and why they are there, because it works perfectly fine for me and I've never had to try to fix those errors, so don't worry about it. Anyway, with your controller now connected, you should see an option to edit the controller's profile. This is where you choose what buttons to do what, and you can also change the light bar and stuff here too. If I was to play Forza, as that does have support for an Xbox controller, I just simply choose to emulate an Xbox controller, and then when I start Forza, it would work perfectly fine. If you want to play a game which doesn't support any controller though, then click on the buttons to remap them to the keys on your keyboard. So for games where the WASD keys are used to move, you would input them to L3 as the forward, left, right and back motions on the stick. Then, when you go into that game, your analog stick should function just as it would if the game had native controller support. Once all your settings are configured, you can either minimize this or keep it open, but go ahead and start up your game. On Forza for instance, here it believes I'm using an Xbox controller, and the game plays perfectly fine and as it should, and even plays with vibrations, and I did notice that too. If you were to play a keyboard and mouse game, the same thing would happen and your controller would work exactly as you'd expect it to if you were just playing this on your PS4. If you are having any problems with this method, then please let me know in the comments and I'll be sure to respond to try and help to fix your issue. If this video did help you out, then also consider hitting that like button and also subscribe so you don't miss out on another one of my must-see PlayStation videos. If you want to learn how you can increase your PS4 internet speed, then click the video on screen now. Anyway, that's all for me in this video, and I'll see you in the next one.